In this video, we are going to discuss the second subsection of cash flow statement. This subsection deals with investing activities of the business. On the screen, you will see a format, a template of the investing activities. First, we show the inflows and then we have the outflows. The inflows can result from proceeds of sale of any fixed assets, any investments being sold by the company, any sale of intangible assets, or any income received on the financial investments made by the company. Also, there is a possibility that a company gives out its fixed assets on rental basis, on lease basis. Any income received can also be shown here. The outflows of the cash from investing activities will include the purchase of various fixed assets, any financial investments or any intangible assets. And then you have the net cash resulting from the investing activities. So compared to the first subsection where we discussed the operating activities, which was more complex, this subsection is relatively simpler. On the screen, you see the same profit and loss account, and I also have the balance sheet. We have used this balance sheet income statement in the previous videos as well. However, there is more information that I have detailed here in order to now discuss the investing activities. So the additional information that we have now is on the depreciation amount. So it says this non-cash expenses are depreciation, and the breakdown of this depreciation has been presented. In addition to this, we have some breakdown of the fixed assets. So the fixed assets, which are 1,08,000 and 1,20,000, they have been broken down into four different fixed assets because we need to look at which asset was bought or sold during the year. So we have this information available to us. So using this format, we are going to look at each of these items which may go here, and accordingly prepare this subsegment. So in the inflows, we will have proceeds from sale of fixed assets. So let's go to the balance sheet and identify any fixed assets which may have been sold during the year. So in the fixed assets, we have the details for 2019 and 20. So we should be careful in judging the movement, the direction of change. So for land, we have 60,000 in the beginning and 50,000 in the end. That means the account balance, the balance of the land is going down. The value of the book value of the land is going down, which could mean that the land is being sold. So I'm going to write here additional information. We do not have any other information about land. Even if we look at the depreciation, this is on building and on machinery. So about land, we have no additional information. Therefore, the outcome is that we are going to treat this change, the reduction in the value of the land, as sale of land worth rupees 10,000. And we are going to bring this amount to sale of land, sale of fixed asset. So we are going to write land 10,000 and done with the first fixed asset. So this is done. Let us go to building. Building increases from 20,000 to 30,000. We could easily categorize this as the purchase of new building worth 10,000. However, we have some more information about building, which is as follows. There is a depreciation of 5,000 on building, which means depreciation would be charged on this balance at the beginning of the year. So there is a depreciation of 5,000, which means the value of the building at the end of the year would have come down to 15,000 only. So this would become 15,000. And however, at the end of the year, you have 30,000, you know, in the as the balance in the building account. Therefore, the additional 15,000 is what is the purchase. So purchase is not only 10,000 but 15,000, because it is going, the balance is going up by 10,000, but there is also a reduction of 5,000 in the balance, in the value, book value of the building. Therefore, we are going to treat this as the purchase of building 15,000. So I am going to write this in the outflows. Purchase of fixed assets, building. The amount is 15,000. There you go. Then you have machinery. Machinery was 8,000 and now it is 18,000. Again, a 10,000 increase could indicate a purchase of machinery during the year. However, we know there was reduction in the value of machinery due to depreciation and the amount was 3,000. So this 3,000 would have reduced this value of 8,000 to only 5,000. Therefore, at the end of the year, if the value of machinery is 18,000, that means 13,000 rupees worth of machinery has been purchased. So I'm going to show a 13,000 as the purchase of machinery. And purchase is an outflow, so I'll put brackets, parentheses for both the numbers. Done. And then you have investment. Now investments are going up. Additional 2,000. Do we have any information about investment? We do not have any other information about changes in the value of the investment. So we are going to treat the whole 2,000 as the purchase. 2,000 is the purchase of new investment. Money has been put in into some financial investment, 2,000. So 2,000, I will write investment. Investment. So done. And that's it. So now we have covered all these additional information about the investing activities. So one more time, investing activities can include sale of fixed asset, proceed from sale of investment, intangible asset, and there can be interest or dividend received. Now we have to look for interest and dividend received. We have covered all possible we have to cover all the possible sources and uses, and we have covered that except for interest and dividend that could be received on the financial investments. Now if there is any income from the financial investment, that should be shown in the profit and loss account, and there you go, you have an interest on the financial investment. This is 1,000, so we should just show it here, 1,000 as interest. This is the income. Other than this, on the income side, on this credit side where all the incomes are shown, there is no other income that has been shown. Therefore, you cannot add any other inflows as a result of financial income on the financial investments. If there was any rent on the received on the fixed assets, that would also be mentioned here, and you can just pick it up from the income statement. That's it. That's all the information that was required, and we are going to just sum this up, and you'll have the net cash flows from or used in investing activities. So it turns out that the negative numbers are more. So this is 18, 28 and 30,000, and then positive numbers are only 11,000. So you have 19,000. Let me write it here. 19,000 outflow. This is the net result of investing activities. You are not getting any cash. You are using the cash in the investing activities of the business. There you go. That's it. This is how you figure out the changes in the in the fixed assets, in the investments, and you decide whether these are purchases or sales, and you figure out any incomes on the investments, and you get the cash flows used in or cash flows from investing activities of a business during a financial year. I'll see you in the next video.